for a reason.
I mean, Apostle's a god. That man is a lab.
He's
demon.
Really good.
Yeah, for sure.
He complimented me in my text, and I'm like, man, you still ruined me with Squirtle, so what's the point? But speaking of ruin, we got these two coming out. Grenade and Nikita always going to be happening here soon.
And but already, AOS is applying just the zone-breaking pressure that Zero Suit Samus is known for. This is a character that I describe as like the ultimate changer. Mm-hmm. The problem is that Zero Suit Samus can apply tons of safe pressure, but also can be super campy with Flip Kick, getting out of those situations that she does not want to be in. Against Snake, it is interesting to see what AOS is going to choose, what playstyle he'll favor.
When kind of watching AOS and some of the online events from the past few months, I've really kind of realized that Flip Kick is the nah, I'm good move.
Oh, yeah.
It's just like, hey, you're in trouble at all? Nah, I'm good. Instantly back, no problems at all. Like, look at that. Like, I don't have any problems.
I was surprised that it was the up B that got nerfed in Zero Suit instead of Flip
Kick. Yeah. But hey, the dev team is always a little bit wacky with some of their things, so who knows. And oh my goodness, Flip Kicking right into a mortar, that's tough. And that's what happens when you rely on that a little bit too much, because it can make it difficult to really ascertain what's happening if there's a lot of big buttons and explosions on the screen, courtesy of Snake. And speaking of courtesy of Dark Thruntway, that stock, unfortunately.
I am really surprised that we saw that air dodge instead of a C4 recovery. Perhaps mm-hmm. Dark did not realize that he did not have the double jump.
Yeah, kind of a weird air dodge, unfortunate. But hey, you still have a little bit of percentage lead against AOS right now, so if you can just keep locking them down with these projectiles, anything can happen.
I love the crouching. Zero Suit Samus is famously has a lot of difficulty hitting characters that are lower to the ground because that neutral air is not particularly high on the character's launch.
Mm-hmm. So the hitbox is always a little bit deceptive, and looking for something there, not quite finding it. A nice way down, and I like that. Not finding the grab, though. Trying to clank with something. Oh no, getting caught with that laser.
AOS went for the greedy. AOS wanted to end it with that down smash, so I respect the option, but did not quite work out for him.
Just flip kicking around him, not getting like a boost kick or anything crazy, just getting on in there. Can we do it? Ooh, I love that conversion with the back air. So decisive.
Great ledge pressure so far by AOS. It feels like when Dark hasn't really been able to set up a camp game whatsoever. Like, it's been one grenade pull, and then he gets pressured,
no.
And the flip kick coverage right there. Dark, a little bit slow, choosing any option off stage, and AOS hits him with the checkmate early on that stock.
My goodness, that is brutal. So hopefully Dark can go back to the drawing board just a bit. I want to see if he can. I mean, maybe he's going to go Palutena. Maybe he's going to pull up something else. Mm-hmm. But he did some good stuff at Snake that game, and I just want to see him capitalize in it more and not just get mowed down by AOS. But AOS has that effect on people. Sometimes, like, his speed will just make you feel pain.
Oh, yeah.
And that's just it.
It's Zero Suit Samus, you have to be very decisive in the options that you're choosing, and it appears as though, for decisiveness, Dark is getting off of Snake, more of a reactive character who wants to set up defense, to Palutena, a character that can actually box and provide air-to-air combat in spades.
Mm-hmm. And of course, look at that tag, Dark Diff. Dark is trying to prove that this
he
is the Dark.
He feels different.
He really is. The Dark difference is real, and if he can make it shown here today versus AOS, it's always going to be a fun one to see.
Good mash, but the air dodge directionally afterwards, perhaps not the best option, gets the toss, but not the back air. Great DI by AOS at these mid percents. Man was really trying to ladder him.
It really was.
This is an interesting stage to pick against Zero Suit, because Zero Suit definitely still has ladder combos on this stage.
For sure. So hopefully AOS can kind of keep that in mind. And Dark just tries to avoid it like his life depends on it, because hey, it does.
Just flip kicking in neutral. Don't touch me.
Was supposed to flame to kind of cover some options there. AOS, I like that, actually, turning around with that back air, causing some damage.
Back air string, not quite working out. AOS does it again. He basically baits out an aggressive option from Dark, and then just drops down ledge jump.
Mm-hmm.
And then makes it back and gets the berry into up-B kill. A little bit of a nerf on that up-B, but not really that bad when it comes to kill power, especially on a stage like this with not too high ceiling.
A couple frames slower when it was already amazing frame data-wise, so nothing crazy happened to ZSS. And hey, Palu got nerfed too, but she's still an amazing character. That crab is not obscene anymore, it's just good.
I shed a single tear for all the Palu mains out there who can't, like, you know, have a Smash 4 Bowser level of broken grab.
I like that dash attack, creating pressure against AOS, and Dark needs to make this difference a bit more clear because it's looking a little bit rough right now. Almost a full stock in deficit. And that berry?
Be it. No, great mash by Dark.
Mm-hmm. And getting the punish with that up air, that's a nice way to secure the stock.
I'm a bit surprised we haven't seen Dark use a lot of like teleport cancels or anything like that for movement on these stages. Typically, Triflats are Palu's stage, but if you're perhaps like a mid-level player and you haven't like labbed that tech, mm-hmm. you're losing out on a ton of mobility.
But of course, this is Dark Difference. This is probably top one in the world to drop into that laser whip, unfortunately. But hey, the Dark Difference might come out here in just a bit. You never quite know when that man's about to pop off on you. And hey, look, there's a quick way to start some combos, get some percentage on the board.
True so far. It's great pressure by Dark. We've got to go ahead and see something change here. His ledge pressure has been a bit weak as of late. AOS does get clipped that time, but managed to make smack center stage, gets the up smash, now forcing Dark high and back to ledge. No double jump here.
Yep, looking down. Oh, AOS wanted to end it right there. He couldn't find it. Both of them not really finding what they wanted, unfortunately, in that situation. That's no tech. That's a boost kick. What are you going to do?
There's no double here.
Oh, no. This is looking rough for Dark.
Overextension by AOS, though, and very smart by Dark to go ahead and aim for the top platform.
Mm-hmm. That was very smart. Do we get the berry? Do we get the boost kick? No. Try to find the back here, but not quite finding it. But this is rough right now for Dark. Try to get the first edge guard, gets blasted off the stage, and that is a 2-0 for AOS. Flip kicking like mad.
Flip kicking directly on to the next round of Bracket. Mm-hmm. So I think we are just about ready to start these are the winner side qualifiers for top 24, I believe.
Yes, sir. Oh, actually, no. This next one is actually going to be winners round three. We're going to get the qualifiers to top 24 very soon. I actually need to go play my set first. I'm going to hit the restroom, so sorry I have to stall a little bit by your lonesome scabs, but more power to you, and see you soon.
No problem. Thank you all for joining us on